Hello, this is Mathias Müll for mamoworld.com and welcome to this tutorial about the glitch bundle of Squash & Stretch Pro for After Effects. As with any Squash & Stretch bundle, to use it, just select a behavior you like, choose a sound effect, select a layer and apply it. Now, for text layers, Squash & Stretch ask whether they should be split into individual characters or not. For the glitches, it really depends. Some glitches look better when being applied to individual characters, and others look much better when applied to the entire text. So let's first apply this one to the entire text. Then it looks like this. Now I undo and apply it again, and this time choose to split into individual characters. You see that the result looks very different, and also that the deformation of all characters is very similar. So, to avoid too much similarity, the glitch bundle behaviors come in sets that are intended to be used together. If you take a look at them, you see that they have the same sound, look similar, but are still different. So instead of applying the distort for chaos A to all letters, as we just did, it will look much better to mix the variants A, B, C, and D. To do this, we could undo the last squash and stretch operation again, then split the text with the text exploder tool here, and then apply Squash and Stretch Pro to each letter separately. But there's actually no need to undo. We can simply overwrite the behavior we already have applied. So we make sure we are exactly at the point in time where we applied Squash and Stretch before, so here at the first keyframes. And then we make sure that no sound is selected, since we already have the sound in the composition. And now we select a few of the letters randomly and apply variant B. Next, we select again some letters randomly and apply variant C. Finally, we also apply variant D to some of the letters. As you can see, now the result looks less regular and much more chaotic. So, when you decide to apply a behavior to each letter separately, it usually makes sense to mix the different variants. On the other hand, sometimes it will look better to distort the entire contents at once. So in this example, we want to have one single distortion for the entire content, including the logo and all the texts. To do this, we select everything that should be affected by Squash and Stretch, in this case everything except the background layers, and precompose it into a single layer. If we now apply Squash and Stretch to the precomp layer, you can see that everything deforms as a single object. But somehow it does not yet look good. The problem is that the precomp we created is the same size as our composition, so it is much bigger than the actual content that we want to deform. So let's undo the application of Squash and Stretch again and draw a mask roughly around the area of our contents. Now we precompose a second time, but this time using the precompose and crop to content size tool of Squash and Stretch. This tool notices the mask and will crop the precomp to the mask size. So now we have a precomp whose size fits to our content. If we apply Squash and Stretch to it, the result looks much better. To sum up, sometimes the glitches look best when being applied to each element in your scene individually. In this case, make sure to use all variants of the set to get less uniform results. And sometimes it will look better to apply just one Squash and Stretch to the entire precomposed scene. In this case, make sure to crop the precomp to the actual content size to get best results. And one last tip. A big part of the glitch effects are actually the sound effects. You rarely want to use them without sound. So, in the Squash and Stretch preferences, I recommend to set the default sound effects to first or random, such that a sound effect is automatically enabled when choosing a new behavior. This makes browsing the behaviors much faster. Again, this is Mathias Müll for mamoworld.com. Have fun with Squash and Stretch and see you in the next tutorial.